Have a few extra cards lying around? Looking to turn your rotating staples into a Theros booster box? Check out Channel Fireball's online buy list. We offer the most competitive prices on all of your unwanted cards, and we send payments fast via check or PayPal. If you're not looking for cash, we offer a hefty 30% store credit bonus. Head to channelfireball.com/buylist to submit your buy order. It's fast, it's easy, and as LSV would say, it's good value.
Hello and welcome. My name is CalebD, recording here for channelfireball.com. I'm about to run this masterpiece through a set of testing matches against people in the two-man queues on Moto. Kind souls generous enough to donate me their tickets. The main idea behind this deck came up that Stronghold Gambit, I was playing it in the sideboard of Mono Red Sting Attack, and it was so effective and so fun to use because there's not actually that many creatures in Legacy that I thought it could potentially be a main deck card. Kind of making up for some of the weaknesses of Tinfin's. Part of Tinfin's problem is that if the opponent has an abundance of graveyard hate, it can be hard to win, and Stronghold Gambit is kind of this alternative way of getting a Grizzlebrand or an Emrakul into play and just winning the game. So I thought it was worth testing. And then, of course, if you're main decking it, you want more ways to ensure that your opponent doesn't have a creature in hand, so four Thoughtseize, four Cabal Therapy, and I thought Hymnaturok was worth testing. Clearly, two mana is a lot for this sort of deck, and so if anything's going to get cut, I imagine it will be. I was not the happiest with looting effects in this sort of build before, but perhaps with more Emrakuls, the Faithless looting into Shallow Grave or Goryeo's Vengeance becomes more common, so I thought like Faithless looting was worth testing too. In the sideboard, we have a kind of transformational plan, like we take out pretty much all of the reanimation effects and entombs, and then we can just bring in like a pile of sneak attacks and through the breaches and fast mana, which is kind of sweet because the opponent's bringing in Gravedigger's Cage, Surgical Extraction, Black Leyline, that sort of thing, and we can just circumvent it entirely. There's also some rebs and duresses for different sorts of disruption, like fighting through a pile of counters, and they have their uses too. So, without further ado, let's get into some Legacy matches. Alright, on the play against Samwise Gigi, pretty reasonable player. We don't have a turn 1 kill here. It might turn into a turn 2 kill. I guess we'll just see. If he, like, Thoughtseizes out the Shallow Grave or something, then we can maybe go for a turn 3? Or just him on turn 2? I don't know. We'll see. I'll probably just go for it. Stronghold Gambit. Maybe I'll therapy him. Therapy him for Force of Will. See what the hand is. I kind of like that. And then if he has a creature in hand, I can him him next turn and maybe hit it. We do hit Force of Will in his hand, and it looks like we're going to play a Grizzlebrand this turn, because there's no creatures there. Interesting stuff. It's all coming together. I'm actually going to draw 7 with this Grizzlebrand immediately. Wow, this deck is... this deck is hysterical. There's a few different reasons to draw 7 immediately. Like, maybe I can just kill him this turn. Maybe I want to discard. We are... Oh no, this is the win. I was thinking about casting a second Stronghold Gambit, but this is pretty sweet too. Oh, yeah. Now, we do lose some value in our graveyard because we have to shuffle this Cabal Therapy back in. But fortunately, we win the game on the spot, so it doesn't matter. That was... that was a particularly good opener. So, Red Elemental Blasts and Duresses both look pretty good. I kind of want to board in the sneak attack package. Because he probably has some sweet graveyard hate. So, I'm not sure how good Stronghold Gambit is against this deck, but it looked pretty good that game. So I'm just trying to make the deck less reliant on the graveyard synergies. I don't know, like 5 Gorio's Vengeance. We cut these. We have 9 slots. That fits perfectly. But we want to make room for like Entombs and Duresses and stuff. So I might just cut like even more of this. I wonder if I can just fit it all in. Like just cut all of that. All of that nonsense. Like maybe this is just the reasonable thing to do. Like just turn into a really wonky sneak attack deck with a pile of Stronghold Gambits. Yeah. Because, I mean, he's going to be bringing in some form of graveyard hate, and maybe I can just brick it.